Hello everyone and welcome to New Tech Tuesday Tutorials. My name is Richard Evans. Be sure to like, comment, and subscribe. Today I'm going to take you on a tour of an exclusive feature from the award-winning 3Play 3P2 called Keyframe Zoom and Tracking. Now this feature allows you to take captured clips and zoom in and position the clips by adding keyframes, giving you dynamic control over your footage. So, without further delay, let me show you how it's done, son. All right, so here we are in the 3Play 3P2 interface. I'm not going to be doing any recording of these clips today. I'm just going to work with the clips I already have in here. I'm going to be working with the A output, but this will also work for the A output, B output, in either the clip list or playlist, kind of up to you. Okay, so let's go ahead and just start with this particular clip. I'm going to hit play on it just so you can see the action here. So this particular angle, looks like the camera operator is zoomed out and can't really get too clear of a shot. So let's play it out. Gets a little bit closer. Cameraman zooms out. Pass. Dunk. All right, cool. All right, so what I want to do with this particular shot is I want to zoom into this play so I can see everything in a little bit more detail and then zoom out as we get back to the basket, okay? So to do that, we're going to use our different keyframe zoom and tracking features, which are located directly beneath the A output here. So you have these four different icons that we will be playing with today. So this works very similar to Premiere, just not as complicated, thankfully. So let's go ahead and let me zoom through this shot. I'm going to use my jog wheel here. So this will kind of serve as our timeline marker, etc. So what I want to do is I want to start my first keyframe right at the beginning and zoom into this shot. Okay, so there's basically the way to do this is you can use your mouse, or there's another method that I'll show you at the end of this video, but let's just go through on the mouse side first. So what I'm going to use on my mouse is my scroll wheel up and down to allow me to zoom into the shot. So let's go ahead and do that. I'll scroll in, and then you'll see that my cursor has now become a directional cross here. So let's move that a little bit centered. Boom, all right. And now you'll see that I have my first keyframe right here in the beginning. You can see that little white tick mark. That means that I have a keyframe. Now I'm going to show you something that you need to be aware of, and don't do it. All right, so right now you'll see that my save icon is blinking, meaning that I have not saved this. And if I don't save this and say navigate to a different clip and then come back, well, I just lost that keyframe. So I got to do it all over again. So keep an eye on that whenever you're using this feature, because you might need it. All right, so let's do that again. I'm going to start my first keyframe by clicking that. Zoom in. Get that. Okay. And now I'm going to use my jog wheel. And I'm going to follow the ball. That's pretty good. But then around here is where his head gets out of frame. So I'm going to back up just a tad and put another keyframe here, not make any changes, so that those keyframes stay the same. So I'm still zoomed into that particular shot. And then let's move a little bit further forward. And from here, let's start to zoom out. So again, I'm going to use my mouse cursor wheel. Back up a little bit and get this more centered. Let's back up a little bit more. All right, decent. All right, let's move a little bit further down the clip. Oh, look, see, getting out of shot here. So from about here, let's go ahead and pan up a little bit. All right. And we'll keep going. Every time I do this, you'll see that I add another keyframe here on that timeline. All right. So looks like the cameraman started to zoom out a little bit here. Let's just go ahead and follow what he's doing, because that we don't want to put too many zooms in when he's doing a zoom out, because that could be a little bit weird to the eye. But let's just go ahead and position this a little bit more in the center. Come around here. And around here is where we need to zoom out all the way. So again, I'll move this back. All right, now I haven't been hitting save in here for a reason, because I want to, you know, kind of make myself learn a lesson here. So I'm hit save, and now I've saved all these different keyframes. And then let's keep advancing. All right, and let's zoom out right about there, all the way out. All right, so we can get all of that. All right, so I don't have to hit that keyframe button every time when I do this. I'm just doing it because it kind of makes it easier to do. But let's go ahead and hit save on that. and then we'll advance through. We'll just leave this go to the end of the shot. All right, pretty good. Okay, now let's say that you want to delete a certain keyframe here. All right, so let's say I'm going to add just a superfluous keyframe in here, just right here. Boop. All right, now let's say I want to get rid of that one. All right, I'm going to hit save, and it's in there. What I can do now is use these directional arrows to move between my different keyframes. So that one goes to the left, this one goes to the right. And let's go ahead and delete that. And to delete it, you just simply click on the keyframe button again, and it is gone. Let's hit save, make sure it saves the changes. Good to go. Okay, so let's hit double stop here, and let's hit play. You'll see it's already zoomed in because when I first started this, it was on the first frame. So let's hit play and see how that looks. All right, so we've got a close shot here. All right. Boop, not too bad. It can be a little bit better, but it's not too bad for a little example. All right, so pretty good. So now what I want to show you next is I've saved this, the keyframes, onto this clip, and you can tell that you've done that by looking at the clip in your clip list. You'll see that there is a icon here in the bottom right, which is the keyframe logo, which means that this clip has keyframes in it. So if I want to put this particular clip with the keyframes into my playlist, all I have to do is click Add to Playlist, and then you will see in my playlist here, this particular clip has that same key icon, meaning that there are keyframes in there. Now let's say that you want to get rid of one of these, you don't want it in there. All I have to do is simply right-click on the clip itself, select Delete Keyframes, and we're back to normal. But it does not affect the other. So if I delete the keyframes here, it does not touch them there, and vice versa. So keep that in mind as well. Okay, so I'm going to go ahead and do this all over again. Let me right-click on this, delete all the keyframes, and I want to show you another method of setting up your different keyframes for keyframe zoom and tracking. All right, and here's where we're going to have some fun. So I've gone ahead and got rid of my control panel out of the way because I want to show you that you can also use a wired Xbox controller to control this particular feature. All right, now this is just a cheap little Xbox controller. Make sure it's wired and installed before you get into your session to make this work properly. But let's go through all the different controls on here to set up your keyframes. All right, so first, let me show you on this side. So you have your left trigger and right trigger. This will allow you to move forward and backward within your clip. All right, and then the left bumper and right bumper are what's going to allow you to move between the different keyframes, just snap to those keyframes. But I don't have any keyframes yet, so let's go ahead and start that. So to zoom on with using the controller, you would use your right thumbstick. And we'll just zoom in here. Whoa, a little too far. And then I can use my left thumbstick to position this. All right. Now, as soon as I've done that, again, it already has set up a keyframe on the interface here. But if I wanted to, I can hit save by clicking the Y button, and that will make that flashing save icon go away. And then also, let's go ahead and let's start to move through our clip here. I'm going to use my my right trigger here to move forward. All right, and that's still pretty good. Move a little bit more. And that's where his head starts to get out of frame. So from here, I'm going to start up a new keyframe by using my right thumbstick. Let's back that up just a tad. Right, and let's center that just a little bit more. All right, advance my clip a little bit more. From here, that's where it starts to get kind of out of sorts. So I'll use my left thumbstick to move that up. Let's move a little bit further. And yeah, that's still pretty good. That's where the cameraman zooms out. All right, and let's move this here so he's still in the center. And keep advancing. Yeah, still I'm a little close up right here. So right about here, I want to zoom all the way out. So I'll use my right thumbstick, zoom all the way out. And we're good to go. I think that's pretty decent. All right, so let's move between our different keyframes. And I can do that again by clicking the left and right bumper. So I'll go to the left. And that'll move to snap directly to my keyframes. All right? I'm going to hit Y here to save that. And let me go ahead and show you another action here. To create a keyframe wherever, I can hit the X button, and that will create another keyframe. Or I can hit X to delete it. So if I wanted to, I can go back here, and I can delete that one. But I don't want to do that. Let's go ahead and zoom all the way out again and hit Y to save it. And we're good to go. Now you can also control your playback from here as well. So if I hit B on my Xbox controller, that will take me to the very beginning of the clip. And if I hit A, it will play my clip. So let's go ahead and do that. I'll hit A, and let's watch that. Go to my first keyframe, backing up. There we go. All right, not too bad. Cool. Yeah, but that's basically how you use the keyframe, zoom, and tracking tool in here. There's no one wrong or right way to do it. Sometimes one method is going to be better for users, and some are going to be better for others. So there's no no wrong or right way. But as usual, plug it in, play with it, and have some fun. Keyframe Zoom and Tracking is exclusive to the 3Play 3P2 and is a powerful tool to help enhance your show. Now, if you like this video and are looking for more new tech tutorial videos, click subscribe on the New Tech YouTube channel available at youtube.com/newtechinc. And if you're looking for formal New Tech product training, I also recommend checking out New Tech University at newtech.com/newtech-u. And that's where you can get New Tech certified, which is pretty awesome. For more information about New Tech products and services, you can contact your local reseller or visit our website, newtech.com, and you can even sign up for a free New Tech product demonstration at newtech.com/demo to see exactly which system is right for you. And if you're posting your work on social media, don't forget to tag us using the hashtags NewTech, TriCaster, or 3Play. Thank you so much for watching. I'll see you again soon for another edition of New Tech Tuesday Tutorials.